Hello! In this video I'm going to show you how to crochet this very cute little bee. This is an easy project to make, great for beginners. I will show everything step by step, also the color changing. And of course you can use any yarn that you like. The small bee is made from sport weight cotton yarn and a bigger bee from chenille yarn and 5.0mm crochet hook. In the video I'm going to use cotton yarn because then you can see the stitches easier than I'm going to make. But I'm also going to show you some tips in chenille yarn when it's necessary. So grab the yarn that you like and then we can make a very cute little bee. And if after this video you want to make more amigurumi, I have many more free patterns and videos available. Please subscribe to my channel, then you will be updated on my future videos. And it would be great if you could leave a comment on this video and like this video. Now this is the yarn that I'm going to use. This is sport weight cotton yarn. But instead of black I'm going to use brown yarn because black yarn is really difficult to see in the video. So I'm going to replace it with brown yarn. This is the 2.5mm crochet hook that I'm going to use. So when I'm using brown and you want a black and yellow bee, just use black instead. These are my needles that I'm going to use. A small one for cotton yarn and a big one for the chenille yarn. Some pins. Oh yeah, and the needles have a blunt point. 8mm safety eyes. En de bags voor de small bee. So these are 8mm. You need of course scissors for the chenille bee, which I'm also sometimes going to show you. I'm going to use some 8mm safety eyes. And this is a bit of stuffing. And now we're going to start with the body. We're going to start making a magic circle. Wrap the yarn around your finger twice. Then go into the two loops with your crochet hook, wrap the yarn and pull it through both loops. Then you're gonna grab the yarn again and pull it to the loop on your crochet hook. That's how you make a two-looped magic circle. If you find it difficult or if you're using, for example, plus yarn, you can also use a one-loop magic circle. I made a video about this. It's in the corner of this video right now. Now we're going to make 6 single crochets into this magic circle. So I'm going to go into the magic circle. I'm going to grab the yarn and I'm going to pull it to the magic circle. Now I have 2 loops on my crochet hook. I'm going to grab the yarn again and pull it through both loops. Now I'm going to make my second single crochet. If this is too fast for you, please slow down the video with your YouTube settings. En de 4th single crochet. De 5th. I need to make one more. And now I've made 6 single crochets. I'm going to close the magic circle by pulling a small piece of yarn. One loop will become smaller. And I'm going to pull on the bottom side of that loop to close the other one completely. Now I'm going to pull the piece of yarn again to close both loops. Now I've made the magic circle, I'm going to start with round 2. But first let me give you a tip for plus yarn. A tip for if you want to use plus yarn. It's probably better to use a magic circle with one loop instead of 2. Like this. And I will also show you how to make it a bit easier to close the magic circle with plus yarn. Because this can be a little bit difficult. So if you've made 6 single crochets, if you start pulling here, it might be a little bit difficult to close. So pull on different places on your stitches. So here and here. And then you will see it will become easier to close the magic circle. I'm going to start with round 2. First I'm going to take a little bit of leftover yarn. And I'm going to place this before I start with the second round. And in the second round, we're going to do an increase in every stitch of the round. That means that we're going to single crochet 2 times in every stitch. So in this first stitch, I'm going to do 2 single crochets. This is the first single crochet, and then the second single crochet. And in the second stitch, also 2 single crochets in the same stitch. So this is the first single crochet, and then the second single crochet in the same stitch. And again, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. I will be doing this in every stitch of the round. So in the end, we will have made 12 stitches. This is the last increase, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And then I'm going to start with round 3. First I'm going to move the marker yarn. And then I'm going to do 1 single crochet in every first stitch. And in every second stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. First move the marker yarn and then go into that first stitch and make 1 single crochet. Then I'm going to go into the second stitch and I'm going to make an increase. 2 single crochets in the same stitch. So on the first stitch, 1 single crochet. In the second, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And repeat this until the end of the round. On the first stitch, 1 single crochet. And in every second stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. So in the end, we will have made 18 stitches. So this is the last increase of round 3. And now we're going to go to round 4. In round 4, we're going to do 1 single crochet in the first 2 stitches, and in every 3rd stitch, we're going to make an increase. So in this first stitch, 1 single crochet. And in the second stitch, 1 single crochet. And in the 3rd stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Then you have to repeat this 5 more times until you have the round. So in every first 2 stitches, 1 single crochet. And in every 3rd stitch, an increase. This is the last increase of round 4. Now we're going to start with round 5. In round 5, we're going to single crochet in the first 3 stitches. And we're going to make an increase in the 4th stitch. So in this 3rd stitch also 1 single crochet. And then in the 4th stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And we're going to repeat this 5 more times until the end of the round. So in every first 3 stitches, 1 single crochet. And then every 4th. An increase. This is the last increase of round 5, and then we're going to start with round 6. Round 6 and 7 are really easy. Just make 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. So you do that for 2 rounds, round 6 and 7. Just make 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. Now we're going to start with round 8. In round 8, we're going to single crochet in the first 4 stitches, and then we're going to make the increase in the 5th stitch. So in this first stitch, 1 single crochet. In the second stitch, 1 single crochet. In the third stitch, 1 single crochet. And then in the fourth stitch, 1 single crochet. And the fifth stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And you have to repeat this until the end of the round. So in every first 4 stitches, 1 single crochet, and in every fifth, an increase. Now this is the last increase of round 8, and now we can start with round 9. Round 9, 10 and 11 are really easy. Just make 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. So you do this for 3 rounds. Round 9, 10 and 11, just 1 single crochet in every stitch. Now, before we start with round 12, we're first going to place in the safety eyes between rounds 8 and 9, with 5 stitches between both eyes. And let me count the rounds. This is round 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and this is 9. So between these two rows, we're going to place the safety eyes. And they're going to be 5 stitches between both eyes. First, I'm going to make a little hole with my big needle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is where I'm going to place the safety eyes. Sometimes it can be a bit difficult to place the bags on the safety eyes, but that's okay, that makes them safer. These are not so difficult, so maybe not that safe. But if you have ones that are very difficult to attach, then I have a tip. Use, for example, this is the cap of a pen, and then you can use some force to put on the washer of the safety eye. Easier. Yeah, but these ones are not that difficult. Now we're going to continue with the next round. In the next round, I'm going to show you how to crochet 2 single crochets together. First, we're going to make 1 single crochet in the first 4 stitches. So in this first stitch, 1 single crochet. In the second stitch, 1 single crochet. In the third stitch, 1 single crochet. Then in the fourth stitch, 1 single crochet. And then we're going to make a decrease. We're going to crochet the next 2 stitches together. To do this, you're going to go into the front loops of the next 2 stitches. So only the front loops. And then I'm going to grab the yarn and pull it through both front loops. And then I'll have 2 loops on my crochet hook. I'm going to grab the yarn again and pull it through both loops. This is called an invisible decrease. I will also show you how to make a normal decrease, because it's easier when you're using plus yarn. When you make a normal decrease, you go into the next stitch, and not only the front loops, the whole stitch, and you grab the yarn and pull it through. You go to the second stitch, grab the yarn and pull it through. And now you have 3 loops in your crochet hook, and you pull the yarn through those 3 loops. Now that's how you make a normal decrease. And for plus yarn, this is much easier. And you won't see the decrease because, well, it's very fluffy yarn. Now we're going to continue with round 12. One single crochet in the first 4 stitches. And then we're going to make a decrease. We're going to crochet the next 2 stitches together. And we're going to repeat this until the end of the round. So in the first 4 stitches, 1 single crochet, and then crochet the 5th and the 6th stitch together. Then we're going to start with round 13. In round 13, we're going to do 1 single crochet in the first 3 stitches, and then we're going to crochet the 4th and the 5th stitch together. So in this first stitch, 1 single crochet, in the second, 1 single crochet, in the third, 1 single crochet, and then we're going to crochet the next 2 stitches together, go into the front loops of the next 2 stitches. Now we're going to repeat this until the end of the round. Now this is the last decrease of round 13. Now we're going to start with round 14. In round 14, we're going to do 1 single crochet in the first 2 stitches. And then we're going to crochet the next 2 stitches together. So in this first stitch, 1 single crochet. In the second stitch, 1 single crochet. And then we're going to crochet the third and the fourth stitch together. We're going to repeat this until the end of the round. So in every first 2 stitches, 1 single crochet. And then a decrease. Crochet the third and the fourth stitch together. Now before I finish this round, I'm going to place the brown or black yarn, whichever you prefer, behind the last stitches that I'm making. So this will be the new color of the new round. So I'm just going to hide the yarn. And then we're going to color change in the last stitch that we're making. So first I'm going to make the first part of my decrease, like this. And then I have 2 loops on my crochet hook. And then I'm going to get the brown yarn and pull it to the loops on the crochet hook. Now I'm just going to hide the yellow yarn behind the stitches that I'm going to make in brown in the next round. First let me place the marker on. I don't really have to do that because of the color change. I can see exactly where my where the new round is starting. So in the next round, I'm going to make 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. So it's a really easy round. And I'm going to hide the yellow yarn behind all the stitches. Now this is the last stitch and I'm going to color change in here. So first I'm going to begin making the single crochet. And now I have 2 loops on my crochet hook. I'm going to grab the yellow yarn and pull it to the brown loops. It is the brown yarn, and I'm going to hide brown yarn in the next behind the stitches of the next round, which I'm going to make in yellow. We're going to make one single crochet in the first two stitches, and then I'm going to make an increase. And I keep hiding the brown yarn behind the yellow stitches. So this is an increase. I'm going to repeat this 5 more times. In every first two stitches, one single crochet. And in every third, an increase, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Now this is the second stitch of my increase, the last increase, and I'm going to change the color of the yarn. And then I'm going to start with the next round, round 17, and I'm going to make the going to hide the yellow yarn behind the brown stitches. This is a really easy round. Just make one single crochet in every stitch of the round. Now round 18, we're going to color change again. And then I'm going to make another really easy round, just one single crochet in every stitch of the round. And now I'm going to hide the brown yarn behind the yellow stitches. Oops. I don't think I need a marker yarn anymore. So I'm going to remove it. And then I'm going to continue to crochet the B. Now I'm going to color change again to brown yarn, and the next round is also really easy, just one single crochet in every stitch of the round. Now, round 20, we're going to color change to yellow yarn. And also going to make one single crochet in every stitch of the round. Now I'm going to make the last color change to brown yarn. And then I'm going to start with round 21. In round 21, we're going to do one single crochet in the first two stitches. And then we're going to make a decrease. We're going to crochet the third and the fourth stitch together. I'm not going to make any more color changes. So I'm going to cut the yellow yarn now and continue with the brown yarn. This is the last decrease of round 21. And now I'm going to put a bit of stuffing in the body. Now let's continue with round 22. First make one single crochet in the first stitch and then decrease the next two stitches. So crochet every second and third stitch together. Now this is the last decrease of round 22. And in round 23, we're going to decrease 6 times. So we're going to crochet every first and second stitch together. Now this is the last decrease of round 23. I'm going to put a bit more stuffing in the body before I make the last round. You probably have to use a little tool. I'm going to use a chopstick to put the stuffing in the body. Now around 24, we're going to make one single crochet in the first stitch and then we're going to decrease the next two stitches. So one single crochet in the first stitch and then crochet every second and third stitch together. So in this first stitch, one single crochet. Now I'm going to crochet the next two stitches together. Now repeat this one more time. So first one single crochet in the first stitch and then decrease. Now the little bee is done and we just have to close the hole. We're going to do this by sewing the remaining yarn through the front loops of every stitch of the last round. Now I can just pull the yarn to close the hole and then I just have to hide the remaining yarn inside the bee. And now we'll show you how to make an antenna. We're going to start with a magic wing. Wrap the yarn around your finger twice. Go into the two loops, grab the yarn, pull it through. Now one loop on your crochet hook, grab the yarn again. And pull it through the loop on your crochet hook. Now I'm going to make 6 single crochets into this magic circle. This is the first single crochet, the second single crochet, the third single crochet, the fourth single crochet, the fifth, just one more, 6 single crochets, 2, 3, 4, 5, just one more. And I'm going to close the hole. I'm going to pull the small piece of yarn. And then you will see that one loop will become smaller. I'm going to pull on the bottom side of that loop to close the other one completely. Then I'm going to pull on the small piece of yarn again to close the magic ring completely. And now I'm going to single crochet in the first stitch and then an increase in every second stitch. Let me first place my marker yarn. And then I'm going to make 1 single crochet in the first stitch. And in every second stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. The next round, round 3, is really easy. We're just going to do 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. In the next round, in round 4, we're going to make 1 single crochet in the first stitch. And then we're going to make a decrease. We're going to crochet every second and third stitch together. So in this first stitch, 1 single crochet. And now we're going to crochet the next 2 stitches together. You have to repeat this 2 more times until the end of the round. So first 1 single crochet. And then decrease. In round 5 we're going to use brown yarn. That's why I'm going to hide the new brown yarn under the last few stitches that I'm making. And in the last stitch I'm going to change to brown yarn. So first I'm going to start the beginning of the decrease. And now I have 2 loops on my crochet hook and I'm going to change to brown yarn. And the next 2 rounds are really easy. Just 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round in brown yarn. This is the round 6. You have these 2 pieces of yarn sticking out. I'm going to cut them off because then it's a bit easier to crochet my last round. Now I'm going to crochet the last round, which is really easy. Just 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. I'm going to fasten off with a slip stitch in the next stitch. First remove the marker yarn and then I'm going to go into the next stitch. I'm going to grab the yarn, pull it through immediately to the loop on my crochet hook, and then I can cut the yarn and pull it through. Now you have to make one more antenna. Put a bit of stuffing in the antenna. I'm going to show you how, where to sew the antennas. I'm going to sew them on round 3. I will show you exactly how to sew the antennas on the body. I'm using a big pin to put it in place. And then I can sew the antenna on the head. Now, I just have to hide the remaining yarn in the antenna. The other antenna is also going to be sewn over round 3. And again, I will show you exactly how. This is round 3. Now, just have to hide the remaining yarn in the antenna. And now we're going to make the wings. We're going to start with making a magic wing. Wrap the yarn around your finger twice. Go into those 2 loops, grab the yarn and pull it through both loops. Now have 1 loop on your crochet hook, grab the yarn again and pull it through the loop on your crochet hook. Now we're going to make 6 single crochets. This is the first single crochet. And now the second. The third. The fourth. 5 and 6. Now we just have to close the magic ring. I'm going to do that by pulling that small piece of yarn that's sticking out, and then 1 loop will become smaller. I'm going to pull on the bottom side of the loop to close the other one completely, and then close it with a small piece of yarn. Now we're going to start with the second round. First, I'm going to place a marker yarn, and we're going to increase 6 times. So in every stitch of the round, we're going to make an increase, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. So in this first stitch, we're going to make 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Also in the second stitch, 2 single crochets. In the third stitch, 2 single crochets. We do this in every stitch. Now first move the marker yarn. And now we're going to go make 1 single crochet in the first 3 stitches. And then in every fourth stitch an increase. So in the second stitch, 1 single crochet. In the third stitch, 1 single crochet. And in the fourth stitch, an increase. 2 single crochets in the same stitch. You have to repeat this 2 more times until the end of the round. The next 2 rounds are really easy. Just make 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. We're going to do this for round 4 and 5. So for 2 rounds, just make 1 single crochet in every stitch. In round 6, we're going to make 1 single crochet in the first 3 stitches, and we're going to crochet every 4th and 5th stitch together. So in this 3rd stitch, 1 single crochet, and now we're going to make a decrease. We're going to crochet the next 2 stitches together, and we're going to repeat this 2 more times. So in every first 3 stitches, 1 single crochet, and then crochet every 4th and 5th together. This is the last decrease of round 6. Then we're going to start with round 7. In round 7, we're going to make 1 single crochet in the first 2 stitches and then a decrease. So in this first stitch, 1 single crochet. In the second stitch, 1 single crochet. And then we're going to crochet the next 2 stitches together. We're going to repeat this 2 more times until the end of the round. Now this is the last decrease of round 7, then we're going to start with round 8. In round 8 we're going to do 1 single crochet in the first stitch, and then we're going to decrease. We're going to crochet the second and third stitch together. So next 2 stitches we're going to crochet together. We're going to repeat this 2 more times until the end of the round. So in every first stitch 1 single crochet, and every second and third we're going to crochet together. Now I'm going to fasten off with a slip stitch. I'm going to do this by going into the next stitch with my crochet hook, grab the yarn and pull it to that stitch, but also mainly to the loop on my crochet hook. Now I can cut the yarn and pull it through. To make 1 more wing, and now we're going to sew both wings together. First I'm going to flatten them like this, and then I'm going to sew the last rounds that we made together. Now I'm going to fold the middle part and sew it together. And to keep it in shape, I have to sew the middle together. Now we'll show you how to sew the wings on the body, on the back of the body. And now I just have to cut the yarn and then my bee is done. I hope you enjoyed making this cute bee. If you did, please like this video. And I would really appreciate it if you could help my channel by leaving a comment. And of course, subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching. This is the brown bee and the black bee. Please let me know in the comments which color you made for your bee, or maybe something completely different. I also have lots of patterns on my website, and also bigger patterns in my Etsy shop. The bigger patterns, like this cute axolotl, take a bit more time to make. They're just as easy, also this cute koala, but they take a bit more time because, well, they are bigger. And if you make them from bigger yarn, they'll become huge. I also made a book with lots of beginner amigurumi patterns. Thank you so much for watching the video and enjoy making many amigurumi.